Now, Clausius' statement of the second law of thermodynamics. His statement is, it is impossible to construct a device which, operating in a cycle, will transfer heat from lower temperature body to a higher temperature body at its sole effect. What does it mean? I will explain you. Now, this is the source temperature T1, this is the sink temperature T2. Now, from lower temperature to higher lower temperature, some heat is extracted and it is thrown to the source T1. Here, Q1 is equal to Q2. This system is impossible. This device, or in a cyclic process, it is going, it is running in a cyclic process, it is impossible to do this. What is to be done? Some work is to be done on this system. So the what is the equation? Equation will be, here Q1 is taken out from the system, so minus Q1 it is added to the system, plus Q2, heat work is done on the system, minus W, that will be equal to 0. That means Q1 minus Q2 is equal to minus W. What this is equal to, this Q1, actually Q1 minus Q2 is equal to W. So Q1 minus Q2, that will be equal to, this is actually, this is equal to minus W, not 0. Minus Q1 is taken out from the system. Minus Q1 taken out from the system and plus Q2 added to the system. This is the summation of Q, and summation of W is equal to dark, what dark on the system. Okay, so it is W minus W. So Q1 minus Q2 is equal to W. So Q1 minus Q2 is equal to W. Okay. Okay, now this is a cycle, a total cycle of the refrigeration plant. Now this is a body at temperature T2. This suppose is a refrigeration, fruits are there at temperature, lower temperature, then the atmospheric temperature is T1. So refrigerant is evaporated here, so heat is taken out from the body and it is compressed by the compressor, and it is compressed by the compressor and then going to the condenser where the heat is rejected to the atmosphere, and then again this is the turbine or expander, it expands the refrigerant, then this work is done by the turbine and then it is coming to the again the evaporator. Okay, so this is the full system. Now in this system, Q1 is taken out from the system, so minus Q1 plus Q2 is equal to minus WC dark on the system, so it is plus WE. Okay, Q1 minus Q2, Q2 is equal to WC minus WE. Okay, so now what is refrigeration plant? This is the refrigeration symbolic. Now body at temperature T2, Q2 is given and Q1 is given. So only thing is that this is the same as before, the work is done on the system. So what is COP, coefficient of performance of refrigeration. This is nothing but how much heat is extracted from the body and the ratio between this work W net. So Q2 by W net is equal to COP of refrigeration. Q2 by W net. Q2 W net is equal to Q1 minus Q2. So Q2 by Q1 minus Q2. So W net is equal to WC minus WE is equal to Q1 minus Q2. Okay. So now let us talk about heat pump. Now this is a heat pump, cyclic heat pump. So heat pump means this is our important. This is the body is here, body at temperature T1. In the winter season, you have to do the temperature is maintained, T1 higher than the atmospheric temperature, T2. So in this case, what is the COP of heat pump? This is Q1 is our important and W net as before, so Q1 by Q1 minus Q2, this is the COP of heat pump. So if I COP of heat pump minus COP of refrigeration will be equal to 1, just you subtract this from this, so it will be this, it will be 1. So you can see from here the COP of heat pump is more than COP of refrigeration. Okay. Now, actually, there is an equivalency of the two statements of second law of thermodynamics. Now, equivalence of Kelvin-Planck and Clausius statement. This can be proved very easily. Violation of Clausius statement leads to violation of Kelvin-Planck statement. Now, violation of Clausius statement leads to violation of the Kelvin-Planck statement. Clausius statement ki. Now, this is the, suppose this is the Q2 is taken out from T2 and it is given Q2 same amount is given. This is the violation of the Clausius statement at T1. T1 is greater than T2. So what happens, you know, the let us have the engine, this is the Kelvin-Planck statement is the okay. That means it is not violating the Kelvin-Planck. So Kelvin-Planck is Q1 is taken out from T1 and it is Q2 is rejected at T2 and then the W is, we are getting the work from that engine. So Q1 minus Q2 will be equal to W. Here this Q2 in turn is taken out directly, we can group it directly from here. Now you see this Q2 and Q2 we can omit. Q2 is given to the system and Q2 is taken out, so this we can omit. So what we are having, in this direction Q1 minus Q2. So in this direction Q1 minus Q2 and in this direction now W. In this direction W. W is equal to Q1 minus Q2. This is a combined system. Now you see this heat is taken out from the higher temperature is okay, but it is equal amount of work is done by this combined system, which is impossible according to Kelvin-Planck statement. This is the PMM, actually this is the PMM2. Okay, now in the secondly, violation of Kelvin-Planck statement leads to violation of Clausius statement. So let us violate the Kelvin-Planck. Okay, now this is T1, this is T2, Q2 is taken out and Q1, and this Q1 minus Q2 amount of heat is given to the engine and work is done in equal amount Q1 minus Q2, and this work in turn is given to this R, this device. This is a cyclic process, this device. Okay, so there is nothing wrong, but if I combine these two, what will happen? Now this will be Q2 will be in this, from T2 Q2 will be there, from here Q1 minus this, so it will be Q2. So this will be the system in the combined system. Q2 is taken out and equal amount is given to the higher temperature. It is impossible from the Clausius statement. Okay, so these two statements has some equivalency. Okay, if one is not obeyed, other will not be obeyed. So this is the second law, result of the second law, an explanation of the equivalency. Thank you.